In this video, I'm going to show you how to stop some of the glitchiest runs in Madden 21. What's up guys, my name is Cody and I want to thank you for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. Now if you're new to the channel and you don't know what my channel is all about how to become a better Madden player in Madden 21. And if you're looking to improve your game, whether it be on the offensive side of the ball or the defensive side of the ball, I'd highly encourage you to hit the subscribe button as I upload videos every single day that are designed to teach you different things about this game, teach you different things that you can use and apply in your own game plan. Now, if you're new to the channel, like I said, I'd encourage you to subscribe. One of the other things I want to let you know about is my Nickel 335 Wide Defensive ebook. That's what we're talking about today. We're going to be sharing with you a run defense out of it that is really, really, really good for this trips tight end offset, which I believe the trips tight end offset is probably the best shotgun running set in the entire game this year. And so if you want to learn how to lock this up, not just this specific formation, but any run in the game as well as any pass in the game, it gives you pressures and user rushes and different things like that. That ebook is just $15. It teaches you everything you need to know about defense and teaches you everything that you need to know to be able to be successful defensively in Madden 21. So if you have any questions about this video or the ebook, just hit me up via text message. My number is in the top left-hand corner of your screen. All right, guys, so RPO trap alert bubble is a problem. So I want to talk a little bit about this play, and I want to talk a little bit about why it's such a problem. So the normal setup when you face something like this would be to shift your D-line to the right, crash your D-line out of the 3-3-5 wide, and we're using the play. Really could be any play. I'm using the play Mike Blitz 3. You don't have to use that. That could be any play that you want. But basically, you're shifting your defensive line to the running back side. So in this example, we'd be shifting our defensive line to the right. We'd be crashing our line out. And then from there, we're going to basically try to shoot the gap up the middle. The problem with the RPO trap is it basically takes away the ability that you have to be able to shoot the run like you normally would. Okay. Sometimes you'll be able to blow this up, but you'll actually be interested to know that a lot of times this run is very hard to stop. As you can see, gets through there. It's very difficult to stop. So we have to change, we have to adapt, and we have to learn how to deal with this. So the beauty of the 3-3-5 wide is it can literally deal with anything because of how multiple it is. So you see there, the center is blocking me every single time. It's very difficult for me to get in. So what do? Well, you change your front because you know that you're playing a different formation. So for example, you could try something like this, right? A lot of people will try this right here. They'll basically shift their line to the left. The problem is you see that that guard on the backside comes over and basically blocks me. So what do? Here's your setup. All you're going to do is you're going to call the play Mike Blitz 3. You can call whatever you want, though. And what I like to do is I like to pinch my defense. I'm going to crash my defensive line out. And I'm going to put both of my defensive outside linebackers in vertical hook zone. So basically clicking their icon manually, the square linebacker and the X linebacker, and I'm going to put them in vertical hook zones. From that point, all I'm going to do is at the snap of the ball, I'm just going to run straight. Now, you won't always blow this run up as a user, but you'll have people there that will basically help you stop the run. Okay, you're not always going to be able to blow this run up as a user. Again, I would stand almost like right there, but you see they almost will always shed it, or they're almost always be in the area. So that is kind of my approach. The one other thing that I would say is if you can move your safeties down and maybe almost even do like a crisscross of the lineman, and there you see that the safeties on the linebackers will basically over pursue and they'll be able to get in there. Now, one of the things that you have to remember is that this is a bubble screen, so you do need to pass commit whenever you call or whenever you run this defense. But as you see, your nose tackle will basically just run right through and be able to stop it. Now, you might be thinking, well, this is going to be wide open to the inside zone. Well, the beauty of this is that, you know, again, you'll see here, I'm just kind of sitting back here with my user and just kind of cleaning it up, and I can shoot right through the middle against inside zone and be able to take that away for about five yards. Then the next thing that, again, and like I said, if you can get these safeties down, it does help a ton. But the next run we need to deal with is the RPO buck, which is like the buck sweep. And what you'll see is that run doesn't even get off the ground. It takes too long to develop. It's just not you know, it's not something that's going to work well. Against runs like a trap, you know, something like an RPO trap, I recommend, and I know that the run is really designed to take advantage of an over-aggressive gap shoot, which is what trap is really designed for. It's what makes it so good in this year's game, because run D is all about, you know, gap shooting. But what you'll notice is even if I drop my linebackers back, as long as I'm pass committing, you know, I'm going to be relatively okay. The linebackers are going to kind of cut off anything to the outside. And as you can see right there, that time he got through, I don't think I was doing the right adjustment on my defensive line. But again, you can simply pinch your defensive line, you know, or pinch. I like to pinch the whole defense and then basically bring these guys into the gaps. And then from there, you know, you pretty much have it. The five-man pressure works really good too. Like if you blitz five, you see they're going to come right in and they're going to blow this run up. So these are simple things that you can do to deal with this run. These are definitely, in my opinion, the best runs in the game from a shotgun perspective. They're just really hard to shoot. And so you can't just rely on, oh, I'm just going to shoot the run like you normally would. But I mean, you see right there, like if you crash your line different directions, it does definitely change the angles of the lineman. Another little tip is you could, if you wanted to, especially out of this defense or this formation, you could crash your line to the right. You'll see your defensive lineman will almost always get an instant shed and get in the backfield and be able to handle that. But this has been a little bit about how to stop this run. Obviously, the counter run is very good as well. But the problem with the counter run is, once again, it doesn't always get off the ground. Yes, it does work some. But because of the timing that it takes to be able to get this counter run, again, you're just crashing your line out. You see them run counter, then you can just literally almost run right in here and blow it up. And then obviously you have your safeties coming down as well. So that's a little bit about how to stop the run from this. This is definitely, in my opinion, the best shotgun run that I've faced all year. Is this one right here. But if you can consistently stop this, this formation has some things they can do from it from a passing perspective, but it's not, you know, it's not like crazy, crazy good passing. I mean, the passing is definitely, you know, definitely not as good as the running from this. This is definitely a run first formation. It is a very good run, but if you use some of the tools that I shared with you today, you're going to be able to take care of that. And also, you know, in the ebook, we show you how to shoot every run in the game. We show you how to literally lock down everything. So if you want to get that full ebook, that is just $15. If you're just watching this, maybe you're still sitting on the fence, you don't want to get the ebook yet, I would encourage you to take a look, at least look at the free sample to it. There's a 1-hour video that I did on this that is a free sample that kind of introduces and shares with you some of the core concepts from the defense. And you can get that video just by texting me. All you got to do is just send me a message. My cell phone number is 812-216-3644. I want to thank you for watching today's video. And if you have any questions, again, be sure to text me. My number is in the description. Thanks for your time. And if you want to get that defense, it's just $15. Best defense in the game. You'll see every pro player, almost every pro player will run this defense. And there's a reason why it's that good. And again, that link to pick that ebook up, it's just $15, is in the description. Thanks for your time. And we'll see you guys on stream tonight at 10 o'clock p.m. Eastern Time.